Hello student, this is your online session for class 6 for chapter 6, that is editing data in Microsoft Excel 2013. Okay, this is your second part because in first part we already discussed about the selecting cell, changing the cell content, okay, and about copying or moving cell content. Okay, so now in this part we are going to discuss about something new, that is related to inserting new rows and columns, okay, and inserting cells, deleting cell rows or columns. Okay, so student, in this we are going to discuss about the three things, that is first of all, which is related to inserting new rows and columns. So let us start our today's discussion. So student, if you want to require to insert new cell and column, you can easily do that by following some steps. So for inserting row, for if you want to insert a row, you have to follow the following points. So, and the points are as follows, like, first of all, click on the row heading to select the row. Okay, first of all, click on the row heading to select the row above which you want to insert the new row. So here is the first step, that is click on the row heading and select the row above in which you want to insert the new row. Okay, and the second point is click on the arrow next to the insert option in the cell group on the home tab. So first step is click on the row heading to select the row in which row you want to insert the new row. Okay, and next one is click on the arrow next to the insert option in the cell group on the home tab. Okay, and last step is click on the insert sheet row option. So there are three steps which have to be followed for inserting new row. Okay student, and the first one is, that is click on the row heading to select the row above which you want to insert the new row. Okay, now the second step is click on the arrow next to the insert option in the cell group on the home tab, and third is click on the insert sheet row option. So this is all about inserting a row. So now inserting a column. So next is inserting a column. So you have to follow some same steps if you want to insert column, then you can easily insert your column. So the steps are as follows. Step 1. Click on column heading to select the column to the left of which a new column is to be inserted. So in row, first of all, there is a difference. In row, click on the row heading to select the row. Now in the column, click on the column heading to select the column to the left of the new column. Okay. In row, there is a to select the row above which you want to add a new row. Now here, there is a click on the column heading to select the column to the left of which a new column is to be inserted. Okay. So, and next step is click on the arrow next to the insert option in the cell group on the home tab. And this second step is click on the arrow to the insert option in the cell group on the home tab. Okay. Next step is click on the insert sheet column option. So there are three steps by which you are able to insert column. Okay, so let us recall once again. Step 1, click on the column heading to select the column to the left of which a new column is to be inserted. Okay, now the second one is click on the arrow next to the insert option in the cell group, okay, on the home tab. And third one is click on the insert sheet column option. So this is all about inserting rows and columns. Okay, now the next one is inserting cell. Okay, if in some situation if you want to insert a new cell, so you can easily do that. So there are some following steps which help you to insert a new cell. Okay, so step 1, select the same number of cell that you want to insert. Okay, So, and click the arrow next to the insert option in the cell group on the home tab. So, here there is step 1, select the same number of the cell that you want to insert. Okay, same number that you, which number you do you want to insert cell, then first of all select the same number of the cell that you want to insert. Okay, then second one is click the arrow next to the insert option in the cell group on the home tab. Okay, a drop down list is displayed. So next step is click the insert cell option. Okay, an insert dialog box is displayed. It has the following 4 options. So here there are 3 step, there are 4 step. We discuss about 3 step now. So first step is select the number of cell that you want to insert. Okay, now click the arrow next to the insert option in the cell group on the home tab. Okay, click the insert cell option, and then there are 4 options displayed. 4 options are like that. First one is shift cell right. Okay, first option. Second is shift cell down. Third option, entire row. And fourth option is entire column. So there are 4 options available. So and this step 4 is, in the insert dialog box, select the direction in which you want to shift your cell, okay, and then click on OK. Okay, so these are the 4 steps which have to be followed for inserting a new cell. So, and next one is deleting cell, rows or column. So, next term is deleting cell, rows and column. So, if you want to delete some cell, row and column, you can easily do that, okay. So, there are some steps to delete row, columns and cell R. So, let us discuss about these steps. Okay. Step 1. Select the row, column or cell to be deleted. First of all, select the row, column or cell to be deleted. Okay. Step 2. Click the arrow next to the delete option in the cell group on the home tab. So, first step is select the row, column or cell which you want to delete. Okay, and the next one is click the arrow next to the delete option in the cell group on the home tab. Okay, so first of all select the row, column or cell, and the second one is select the delete option. Okay, or now so this is your about deleting cell, row and column. So, and the next is adjusting row height, column width. So here, if you want to adjust the row height and the width of column, you can easily do that. So students, by dragging the border. So there are different ways by which you are able to adjust the row height and column width. So first one is by dragging the border. Okay, and the second one is by using the format option. So there are 2 ways available here. First one is by dragging the border to change the row height. Okay, so let us discuss one of the following. Okay, so first one is to change the row height. So if you want to change the row height, then what are the steps? Okay, place the mouse pointer at the bottom border of the row heading. So here, place the mouse pointer at the bottom border of the row height. Okay, row heading, the pointer shape changes to the, okay, double headed arrow. Now here the pointer changes visibility, like it changes from arrow to double headed arrow. Okay, now drag the bottom border up and down to decrease or increase the height. So here, first of all, place the mouse pointer, and the mouse pointer changes its shapes from arrow to double headed arrow, and you can easily increase or decrease the height of the row. So, and next, to change the column width, then what are the steps? First one is place the mouse pointer at the right border of the column heading. So here, place the mouse pointer at the right border of the column heading. The pointer shape changes to double headed arrow, same as like in row. Okay, Then drag the right border left or right to decrease or increase the column width. So here, place the mouse pointer at the right border of the column heading. Okay, then the pointer will changes its shape from arrow to double-headed arrow. Okay, then you can easily drag to the right border, left or right to decrease or increase the column width. So, student, this is all about changing the row height and about changing the column width. So, this is all about your chapter. So, student, in today's session, we discuss about that is relating to inserting new rows and columns. Okay. Today we discuss about inserting new rows and columns. Okay. Inserting cell in our worksheet. Okay. And deleting cell, row and column in our worksheet. And the last we also discuss about adjusting row height and column width. So this is all about your today's session. So student, be safe. Okay. Stay at home. Okay, thank you.